Ciao friends! In this video, I want to show you some practical usages of calculation groups. We will use Contoso as an example, and I will use calculation groups to create dynamic format strings on a regular measure, and then I will use again a calculation group to perform the dynamic conversion of the unit of measure of the weight of products. Let's start looking at the example first. At Contoso, they have products. And they have the product name, the weight, and the unit of measure that is needed to give a meaning to the weight. So 1.50 pounds, 29 grams, and so on. Now, whenever you have a number and a unit of measure, you need to pay attention when you aggregate values together. Let's try to compute the total weight that was shipped. You can author a simple calculation like this one that computes the weight by iterating over sales and computing quantity times the weight of the related product. The measure works fine and produces a number. The thing is, this number is wrong. You can easily see if you add the unit of measure to the report. You see that audio has grams, ounces, and pounds. These three values cannot be aggregated together. This number for computers is expressed in pounds, and that is correct. But you cannot sum these three values together, which is exactly what is happening if you do not add the weight unit of measure to the report. So what I want to do, I want it on the rows, is something different. I want first to fix this measure and get rid of the total if the total cannot be computed. What I want to build is a calculation like this that does not show the total in case it is aggregating different unit of measures. And I also want to go a step farther. In case I can show a number, I also want to show the unit of measure as part of the result. Now, the problem of showing the unit of measure as part of the result is that the unit of measure depends on the product. If there is only one unit of measure visible, I want to add that unit of measure to the format string. And regular measures do not have dynamic format strings. But calculation groups do. So what I will do is create a calculation group that I called here weight format string. If I use no conversion, it will not do any kind of conversion. But if I use apply format string, then it will show the measure using the dynamic format string. Let's see how I did it. We need to go to External Tools, launch Tabular Editor. Okay. Go to Table, and here is the calculation group that I created. Now, no conversion simply does not do anything. It returns the selected measure. Just need some space because the next measure will be a bit larger. Good. So, no conversion does not do any kind of conversion. Apply format string, on the other hand, does some operations. This is the code of the calculation item. It checks first that the selected measure is the weight. We do not want this calculation item to apply to other measures. And then, if there is only one value for the unit of measure, then it shows the selected measure. Otherwise, it doesn't show anything. If any other measure is the selected measure, then it returns whatever value was put by the user in the report. And this is useful to compute the number. Let's take a look at the format string. It's a dynamic format string, so it is a DAX expression. First, it checks if the selected measure is the weight, as we did before. Then it retrieves the current format string by using selected measure format string and using a default value in case the measure does not have a format string. Then it computes the current unit of measure. This expression returns a unit of measure only if there is only one selected. And finally, the result. If there is a unit of measure, it takes the current format string and the current unit of measure. As you see, the result is that the measure does not show anything in case there are multiple units of measure, but it shows a value here for home appliances and here for music movies because all the values are expressed in pounds. Besides, the format string is now dynamic and it changes for every row. The thing is, we can go a bit farther. What we can do is provide a total even when there are multiple format strings, multiple units of measure. To do that, we need to define the target unit of measure. We will let the user choose the target unit of measure by enriching the calculation rule. What I want to do is this last example, where I have again the same calculation group, but I added multiple values, grams, ounces, and pounds. This is the behavior we have seen so far, but if my user selects grams, then the entire calculation happens in grams by doing the automatic conversion. And of course, a user has the option of changing the unit of measure at will. Let's take a look at how I implemented that. Let's take a look at ounces, for example. This is the code of the expression that again checks that the selected measure is weight, otherwise it will not do anything. If I need to do the conversion, I need to have a table that gives me the factor to use in order to multiply the weight expressed in the unit of measure of the product by the unit of measure that the user wants to use. So this table contains two columns, the source unit of measure and the multiplication factor. We know that the target will be ounces. So ounces to ounces has a factor of 1, pounds to ounces has a factor of 16, grams to ounces has a different factor. Then I need another table, which I create on the fly, that contains the weight expressed in the original unit of measure for the current selection. So I take the values of the current values of the unit of measure, there might be multiple, and I compute first the same unit of measure and then the total weight. I compute the total weight using selected measure because in this way my calculation item can be applied also to other measure in case I need it. Some special words are needed for this expression because add columns creates a table that contains the weight unit of measure and the weight. So I already have the unit of measure. Why do I create another column with the same content? If you look here, I have in unit of measure, the weight unit of measure, which is the column in the model, and I add just an empty string. So the result is the same, but I use this technique to lose the data lineage because I will want to join the result of weight with this conversion table, and that can be done only if both columns do not have data lineage or if they have the same, but in this case I need them to have no data lineage. Finally, I use natural left outer join. This is not a very commonly used function, but it is extremely useful because it makes the join between two tables. So I'm joining weights with the table containing the conversion, and the join will happen based on the unit measure column that appears in both tables. The resulting table contains the unit of measure, the weight, and the conversion factor. So the last step is just iterating over this table, do the final multiplication, and produce the result. Let's take a look at the format string expression that in this case is very simple, because we already know that we are doing a conversion to ounces, so we just take the selected measure format string and we convert it to ounces. As you see, the result is simple, because I have the option of moving from grams to ounces to pounds in a very simple way. You have seen that calculation groups are extremely powerful. We have used for two purposes. First, we use them to force dynamic format strings in regular measures. And then, the second step, we use them to perform on-the-fly conversion of unit of measures. I know, looking at the video, everything seems easy. That's why I suggest you to go to sqlbi.com, read the full article, download the file, so that you can start playing with it and learn by doing. That is the best way to start learning calculation groups and use them in your models. Enjoy, DAX!